person, but 3D. And so I started by making a grappling gun.
So we're just playing this.
And it's my game, so I can do whatever I want. And I'm probably going to improve it later on, but for now, I think it gets the job done. A very important aspect of a parkour game, or pretty much any game, is the movement.
Wow.
So I started by implementing sliding. Basically, if you hold down control, you can slide down slopes and build up speed, and it's pretty cool. Then I got started on wall running. This is actually pretty tricky to get right, so for now, I'm going to leave it at this and then come back to it later. And then I added crouching, so you actually become smaller when you slide. I kept it simple, so I literally just scaled the player down when crouching, which might not be the most realistic or best approach, but it works, so I don't care. So as the movement is coming together pretty well, let's try and add some jumps so we can, you know, perform the pew-pew if you catch my drift.
We just gonna throw Timmy.
Throw Timmy. My first problem. I don't know how to make 3D models. So, and with the help of my boy Big Brack, I started my modeling adventure using ProBuilder. Oh, you're wondering why I'm not using Blender? Blender? More like bleh. And ta-da! It looks fucking terrible. Nice. Whatever, I don't care. Now to make the grappling gun look better. I'm going to try to replicate Will Will's grappling gun because it's fucking amazing. Check him out on Twitter. He's the guy
who makes the game and tons of other cool stuff.
You should give him a follow. For starters, the rope is now coming out of the tip of the gun, which is usually the case, and it's no longer ass color, which is a good start. Then I made the gun rotate towards the rope, which was an easy task for me. I totally didn't spend 5 hours trying to figure out how to do it. I want to die. Anyway, here are the 7 lines of code that took me 5 hours to figure out, because who the flying fuck knows how a quaternion works? What the fuck even is a quaternion? I don't know. Does anyone know? And why is
plus
it
one
a quaternion?
Death.
What is this, alien language? A god? Oh, and I also made the gun move up and down a bit, so it looks more dynamic and kind of like you're holding it, which is pretty cool. Okay, we got guns.
Nope.
What's the point of pew-pews if we don't have anything to pew-pew at? You know, so it's time to make an enemy. And using ProBuilder, I started with a head and worked my way down. And yeah, I don't need to use Blender. This is actually very easy to do with ProBuilder. And here's the result. It's okay. After doing some research, I've decided to learn 3D modeling in Blender instead of ProBuilder. So I created my first model, which is totally not just me following a tutorial on YouTube. Anyway, after that, I rigged my character with another tutorial by this guy, Sebastian Lee. Is that even how I pronounce it? I don't know. Hopefully Sebastian doesn't watch this because he is in a league of his own. Get it? Because Lee, his name is Lee. Yeah. So I finally got my enemy into Unity. Oh, you thought I was going to make the animations in Blender, which would save me a lot of time, something any sensible person would do? Nah, that ain't me, cheap, so I made them in Unity. And there we go, a little idle animation. Now let's check out how it looks in-game from the player view. Oh, that's massive. Almost as big as your mom. And so I scaled him down a bit to match the player's size. Oh, and if you know anything about me, and become a ragdoll. But it looks more like he's trying to do yoga or something. I'm pretty sure that's a yoga move right there. Now, I'm sure yoga's healthy, but we're not trying to make a yoga game here. Come on. We're trying to shoot some bad guys, run on some walls, and other cool manly stuff, you know what I'm saying? So I had to scrap the yoga, and it's now much more like an actual ragdoll, which makes me go actually, yes. Guys, this is literally me after a long day of war. Smash like now if relatable, guys, and also remember to smash subscribe now, snappers. I then tried to make him rotate towards me so he can aim a gun at me, and got some interesting results at first. But eventually I got it working properly, and he will now rotate his body and head to look at you. I also want him to hold a gun and actually rotate his arms towards you, because he's looking more like a traffic director, which is kind of weird. And after some more coding, I finally got him to look at me. Or not. I also got the ragdoll working, so whenever he dies, he will turn into a
ragdoll. If you guys like that, you should comment down below. Well, you should, I don't know.
And his career. It was fairly simple to do, and I also made it a bit smoother with these lines of code. And I made it possible to drop the gun as well, though if you keep doing it, your gun turns into a stick. I'm not really sure why, so I guess you can say that leaves me in a bit of a sticky situation, huh?